Good morning, class. I'm your teacher, Laurie Maitland, and welcome to my YouTube channel, We Are the 80s fan page. Today in music history of 1980, we are going to talk about my favorite Bob Marley album, Uprising. On this album, made from June of 1980, due to the rough and gravelly quality of Mr. Bob Marley's voice, everyone knew that his health was in bad shape and that he couldn't have more longevity. This was the final album from 1980 before his health declined when his life was cut short and then passing away too soon from terminal brain cancer at age 36 on May the 11th, 1981 in Miami, Florida. That's why it came from smoking big cigarettes. This album features my favorite song that we usually dance to entitled Could You Be Love, which it was a successful hit from that year. It also includes redemption songs, my favorite song from that album. So let's play George Stewart's pop cover version of Bob Marley's song.
Old pirates, yes, they're robbing. They sold me to the merchant ships. Minutes after they took me from the bottomless pit. But my hand was made strong by the hand of the Almighty. We forward in this generation. Emancipate yourself from mental slavery. None but ourselves can free our minds. Have no fear for atomic energy, 'cause none of them can stop the time. How long shall they kill our prophets while we stand aside and look? Some say
though I am fascinated with his music that was recorded on this album, I am not happy with the results about the front cover that looked ugly and tarnished, since it lacked the natural beauty made by both art director Neville Garrick and photographer Adrian Boot, which I know is not a work of art that ruined the girl's beauty. And the reason for that was we were crying shedding so many painful tears because there was no model version of this album. Plus, I feel so unhappy about the back cover of Bob and his band, the Wailers, looking so tired, weak, and sick without the i3s. Like I said before, my honest fact is about Bob Marley's album from 1980, Uprising, I am not happy about both the front and back cover because you know why? To me, they look awful when they lack pure delight, pure beauty, and also they lack sheer elegance. What they could have had years ago since 1980 was the picture of Miss Beautiful Supreme looking so young and pretty with a lot of makeup on her face, such as mascara, eyeliner, and eyeshadow on her eyes, blush on her cheeks, and lovely lipstick on her feminine lips that captures the natural beauty, pure delight, and sheer elegance that would have been nicer on both the front and the back cover of this album. So I changed it to the model cover version of Miss Beautiful Supreme looking so pretty, looking so alive and well, and having more longevity now shown on Bandcamp. So let's start the album review together. Side one kicks off with all of my favorite songs that are the best and the strongest, such as Coming In From a Cold, Real Situation, Bad Card, We and Them, like we don't know how we and them are gonna work this out. And side one closes out with Work, like 5 days to go, working for the next day. That I've heard before. Side two kicks off with all of my favorite songs that are the best and the strongest, such as Zion Train, like Zion Train is coming our way. And the second one is Pimper's Paradise. Oh, wow. That's also my favorite. Third one is Oh My God, That's Always the Best. Could You Be Loved? Yes, that's my absolute favorite. Fourth one is Forever Loving Ja. Yes, siree, that is always my favorite. Always religious and so inspiring and very spiritual to my Christian life. So let me keep it that way because it's always the strongest. And side two closes out with my favorite religious folk song, Redemption Songs, which is actually Redemption Song. I like this whole album called Uprising, so I'll give it 100%, an A+, 10 out of 10, and thumbs up. On the back of this album, here are the credits. On lead vocals, rhythm guitar, and acoustic guitar, Bob Marley. On bass, piano, guitar, and percussion, Aston Barrett. On drums and percussion, the late Carlton Barrett. On keyboards, Earl Lindow and Tyrone Downey. On lead guitars, Al Anderson from America and Junior Marvin. On percussion, Francisco Willie under his stage name, Alvin Patterson. And last but not least, on backing vocals, the i3s with group members Judy Mowat, Rita Marley, and Marcia Griffiths. Tyrone Downey, and Junior Marvin. Also, special thanks to Carlton Davis under his nickname Santa. Right now, we're going to play only one song off from his album Uprising, made from 1980, that we can dance to, and it's entitled Could You Be Loved as a High School Dance Version. Thanks for watching, and also thanks for subscribing my channel called We Are the 80s Fan Page, and I hope to see you again sometime. Bye-bye.
Or even try to stop.